We go again with what we started the show out with, the truth. And what is the truth? If Islam claims that the truth is from Jesus Christ and the Torah and all these things, well, they're totally denigrating it, and they're perverting it to beyond recognition.
They're disobeying God's word.
Exactly. Words, yeah. And they're going to be judged according to what we said. And as I read Hebrews 13:4 a while ago, yeah, God will judge them for this type of behavior. But anyway, we're running out of time. I believe we've got about 5 minutes left.
Okay. So, real quickly, there are a bunch of marriages and brief marriages that Ali Dashi didn't come up with. Aisha, for example, felt jealous of the women who offered themselves to Muhammad, presumably as wives, in Sahih Muslim 2:34-53, page 748. But it was okay that a woman offered herself to Muhammad, in Ibn Majah 3:2000-2001, page 304-305. Okay, so some of the other people that Muhammad married, and married is the actual word here, is Mulaika bint Dawood al-Lathia. But when she was told that Muhammad was the one who had her father killed, she basically didn't want anything to do with Muhammad. She said she took refuge in Allah from Muhammad. So she became a Muslim, but she would have nothing to do with Muhammad because Muhammad was the one who had her father killed. This is in Al-Tabari, volume 8, page 189. Muhammad also married al-Nasht bint Rifa' of the Banu Kalab bin Rabia, who were allies of the Qurayza. She was also called Sana. However, she died before Muhammad consummated his marriage with her in Al-Tabari 9, page 135-136. Muhammad married Al-Shamba bint Amr al-Ghafiriya. And when Ibrahim died, she said that if Muhammad were a true prophet, his son would not have died. And Muhammad divorced her for that. And before he consummated his marriage with her, this is in Al-Tabari 9, page 136. Muhammad married Asma bint al-Numan bint al-Aswad bint Sharahil. However, unknown to him, she had leprosy. So when Muhammad found that out, he gave her money and divorced her in Al-Tabari 9, 137.
So he not only is he killing the fathers and husbands of these women he's taken as wives, he's also ending up divorcing a lot of them for various and sundry reasons.
Right. So if you're married to wife or husband and they have some serious physical ailment, and leprosy is serious, then you take care of them or you just divorce them. So anyway, he gave her money at least, but he divorced her. In Al-Tabari 9, 137, Muhammad married Aliyah, but then divorced her in Tabari 9, 138. He divorced Amra, Ibn Majah 3:54, page 233, and 3:20-30, page 226. And Muhammad married Qatalia bint Qais, but she died before they consummated the marriage, in Al-Tabari 9, 138. Muhammad married Gaiza bint Jabir, but when Muhammad went to her, he found her to be an old woman, so he divorced her. So he married her kind of sight unseen, but when he saw she was old, well, then so much for her constancy and, faithfulness
in marriage. Divorced her. So that goes against what the Bible would teach. So he's just violating every biblical command that there is, up and down the line, for all the wrong reasons.
Yeah. He also married Kawa bint al-Hudayl. Both of these are in Al-Tabari 9, 139. He married the daughter of al-Jan, very briefly at least, in Bukhari 7, 181, page 131, 132. There's also an Ar-Rabi, who arguably might have been a wife of Muhammad. After a while, you kind of lose count here, I guess. This is Bukhari 7, 77, page 58. Also, so with all of these, you kind of wonder, was Muhammad really satisfied? Well, he had some marriage proposals declined. All right, Muhammad asked to marry Ghaziyah, and the reason it says in Al-Tabari 9:136 is on account of her beauty, but she declined. Now, Tabari claims she was in a state of infidelity, kind of a slander against her, but doesn't have any evidence on that. A woman named Layla clapped Muhammad's shoulder from behind and asked him to marry her. Muhammad accepted. However, Layla's people said she did a bad thing, so Layla returned to Muhammad and asked him to revoke, that is, annul the marriage, and Muhammad complied. So that's like an almost marriage. In Al-Tabari 9:139, Muhammad proposed marriage but ended up not marrying five different women.
Umhani bini Abi Talib, because she said she was with child. Muhammad obviously changed his mind about marrying her when he discovered this significant fact.
Dubai bint Amir, who was too old, he proposed to Saviyah bint Bashama, a captive, but she could choose between Muhammad and her husband, who was still alive, and she chose to stay with her husband. That was at least nice of Muhammad there to give her a choice.
That's one of those rare exceptions.
Yeah. Habib bint al-Abbas, but since al-Abbas was his foster brother, it wouldn't have been lawful, so Muhammad backed out. All right, that one makes sense. Jamr bin al-Harith. Her father falsely claimed she was suffering from something, and he found that she had been afflicted with leprosy. And this is Al-Tabari 9, 140-141. Now, it's possible that some of these different ladies that are similar may have actually been the same lady with a different name. But either way, it's like there are a lot of wives here. And why was it that Muhammad really needed so many wives? On account of her beauty, to satisfy his lust? It sort of seems that way, but it certainly wasn't because to cement powerful alliances, especially with after he already killed the men in the tribe.
And everything you find here, as we're about out of time, is that Muhammad was simply, as the Bible would describe, a carnal man that simply is fulfilling the lusts of the flesh.
Mm-hmm.
And he's fulfilling every requirement of what the scripture says a sinner would have in what he's doing by his actions. From murder, adultery, to having all the wrong reasons for doing things, it's an amazing thing. Muhammad's actions prove he will not inherit the kingdom of God. The Bible, Colossians chapter 3, verses 4 through 6, says, "For ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye also appear with him in glory. Mortify, therefore, your members which are upon the earth, fornication, uncleanness, inordinate affection, evil concupiscence, and covetousness, which is idolatry, for which things sake the wrath of God cometh on the children of disobedience." End quote. See also 1 Corinthians 5, 9 through 10, Galatians 5, 19 through 21, Ephesians 5, 3 through 5, Revelation 22, 14 through 15, and many more. Repent of Muhammad's sins and turn to Christ Jesus for salvation by a holy God. Acts 16, 31. And just remember, you don't need Muhammad and his ethics. What you need is the Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord of heaven and earth, the King of kings and the Lord of lords. He's the way, the truth, and the life, not Muhammad, and you can tell by the way they live. Thank you very much for being with us. God bless you. Join us again next time.